We'll admit we live for the dramatics, especially when it involves politicians, which is no surprise that top on our list today is the Speaker of Parliament storming Kampala CPS like a distressed mother to rescue female MPs after they slapped around police officers, like really they did. Opposition women MPs say whenever they hold Women's Day events, somehow police shows up to frustrate their gatherings and chaos ensues. After a number of them compared notes, they decided to do something about it. On Thursday, dressed in mournful black gomeses, they held a protest march that would see them deliver their petition to the Ministry of Internal Affairs. Guess who showed up? The police. After a scuffle, they were bundled up onto a police vehicle and driven to Kampala CPS. One speaker, Anita Among, learnt of what had happened. She rushed there and had them unconditionally released. But the women say their protest is far from over.
We took a petition to the speaker and we had a number of prayers. One of them was for her as a woman leader to lead a demonstration. And she said, while she may not be able to lead the demonstration, but she's going to lead the move to ensure that everything we've asked for is going to be dealt with, and she has assured us that there is going to be action taken against all the people involved, and that she's going to write immediately to all the ministers we've talked about for them to appear in Parliament.
This week, the government rescued 211 Ugandans trapped in the Sudan conflict. They arrived at Entebbe Airport on Thursday morning at 2 a.m. The conflict has seen over 500 deaths and hundreds have been injured. This as fighting continues between Sudan's regular army led by General Abdel Fattah al-Burhan and the paramilitary rapid support forces commanded by his deputy turned rival Mohamed Hamdan Daglo. Uganda's ambassador to Sudan, Rashid Yahya Semudu, who was among those rescued, said 50 Ugandans are still trapped in the war. The government is working round the clock to bring them home.
As I've told you, yes, that is the number we have, 300. But in case, because we know, we understand that though the majority of Ugandans live in Khartoum city, but we know there must be some other Ugandans in some other areas of the country, because Sudan is a very big country. In case we are in touch with the Ugandan community to make sure that they feed us with information in case there are any other Ugandans they know. But the effect so far has been in Khartoum and those areas which are surrounding Khartoum.
Also this week, the discovery of dozens of bodies buried in Shakahola Forest near the coastal town of Malindi shocked Kenyans and the world. Cult leader Paul Mackenzie Nthenge is said to have told his followers that if they starved to death, they would meet Jesus. Mind you, he did not starve himself, but the sheepish followers did. As of today, a total of 109 bodies have been found in the forest, some piled together in shallow graves, while others scattered on the ground. 39 people were rescued in the process of starving themselves to death in this very location. And to understand just how powerful this cult leader's hold is on his victims, the rescued people refuse to eat. And like Uganda's Chibwetere, Paul Mackenzie Nthenge is currently in police custody.
Pending the hearing, the determination.
Meanwhile, after several weeks on the run, Karamoja Minister Mary Goretti Chitutu's personal assistant Joshua Abaho surrendered to the police, was charged and remanded to Luzira.
This series shows you that these are not people who will be able to meet the terms of the bond. Whether they be disregarded, they've not demonstrated that capacity. So the statements show, as maybe most publics are, they're either paying back loans or just leaving, really. But if they were told to pay 200 million shillings, if you look at the statements, Your Worship, the bank statements which are attached, the balances do not demonstrate that capacity.
Abaho faces two charges of corruption in relation to the misappropriation of iron sheets meant for vulnerable people in Karamoja.
To not the lion to eat up the lamb.
Lastly, this week, President Paul Kagame praised the reigning peace and friendship between Rwanda and Uganda. He was speaking during General Muhoozi Kainerugaba's birthday celebrations that took place in Rwanda.
Allow you to be the lamb that you are. Meaning, that moment will make you feel secure in who you are. As Africans, as brothers, as sisters, Rwanda, Uganda, maybe and some other Africans. I think people tend to take it for granted that Rwanda is small, that Africa, Uganda, we are poor. So, well, you can have peace, but at the same time, you may not be friends. But this time, I think we have both. We are friends, and we are at peace. Thanks to you, General Muhoozi, for your role in this, and for your conviction, and for being that bridge we used to cross from one side to another.
We went from him being a president and me being an army officer to becoming friends. And the mark of friendship was the cows that he gave me. And I take that very, very seriously. And I'd like to report, Your Excellency, that the cows are doing well. They have produced. You gave me 10 cows, now I have 17 cows from the ones you gave me. So from that point on, really, we became friends with His Excellency.
And also that brings us to the end of our top five. We'll see you next week.